Okay, we've got a commercial real estate update on 5 properties in progress right now. We will start with the lovely Gilbert Square in Mesa, Arizona. Finally, the paint job is complete and that place is looking a heck of a lot more modern now than it used to. I will say it came out a little bit more brown and chocolatey than I had envisioned or had seen in the rendering. So hopefully we can show a nice little before and after here of the building and how we went from kind of a deserty brownish to something a little bit more cool, clean, crisp, and feels a lot more relevant in 2021. So a little bit of the monochromatic scheme, maybe that my wife is such a fan of with houses, has now spilled over into our commercial real estate portfolio. Also at that property, little bumps in the road. So someone destroyed our trash enclosure or ran into it, so we had to rebuild the bricks in that and repaint it. So that's looking better. You may notice that in some of the photos. And then our Mexican seafood tenant, who signed a 7-year lease and put a first month's rent and a security deposit, has officially gone into the witness protection program. So they are nowhere to be found. I'm gonna turn that one over to the property management and legal professionals at this point to figure it out. But focus our energy on backfilling that former restaurant space with another user. So that's 3,200 feet, basically the most visible part of that property, because we have almost everything else filled up in that center. So the renewal option went out to the boxing gym for them to stay for another 5 years. The preschool has asked to take some additional square footage in that building. So congrats, it sounds like they are doing very, very well. And then we have discussions with a COVID testing facility and a letter of intent and lease out for a review with them to take about 1,000 feet. That's just gonna be a month to month deal. And then next to that, a Zumba offer is out. So they would take around 2,900 feet. So that would mean all of the inline space is completely filled up. And then hopefully we get a nice restaurant or food user in that pad building. And that property would be completely filled up as we approach our 1 year of ownership mark at the end of this calendar year. So check that out. We'll link to the photos, the videos, and then the flyers if you know someone looking for space in that trade area. Definitely share with them that pad building that's available there. Moving west, about 5 miles over to the HoneyBaked deal. Renovations are making good progress. So we've got all of the suites cleaned out at this point. They've been taken to vanilla shell. So just the walls have been primed. It's a clean blank slate open so that any business owner or entrepreneur could get a vision for what their space would look like. The cockroaches are gone. The bathrooms have been cleaned up and replaced. The flooring has been taken out of there. So again, blank slate. I think one of the last things that we need to do is go in and get the ceiling tiles kind of cleaned up, which is a chicken and egg thing, right? A lot of people want the open ceilings, but I don't want it to show and look crappy when people go in there for tours. So I'm trying to do the bare minimum to get it looking good with the ceiling tiles, but not overspend the money if someone's gonna come and yank it down and have an open concept ceiling, which of course is what everyone wants now. But you know, some office users want the sound deadening of the drop ceiling. So we'll see, we'll see. The paint rendering for that was going to match the Gilbert Square deal. So that kind of monochrome that came out a little too chocolatey. I feel like it's also too brown on this deal. So I'll show the rendering of what that looks like. And then we found a color I like a little bit more called celluloid. So a deep, deep gray with a nice off white should give it a crisp, bright, high contrast finish. So we've got a fresh rendering back of what that looks like. We should be able to show that here. Landscaping getting done this week. And then you may have noticed there's a little tile band around some of those columns. So I gotta get that either reglazed or chip it out and switch it out to like a stucco band or do something cute with wood to make it look good. I'm not exactly sure, but I know we need to not have old crusty chipped up tiles from the 80s when we're all done with it. So that place is looking good. And then, you know, a couple of fun inquiries. We toured a massage studio. We have a signed letter of intent for a pizza restaurant to take a bunch of vacancy there. And then we had a large medical user inquire about 6,000 feet. Big national credit tenant with hundreds of locations around the country. So if we can get enough power and water and structural support that they need to make that facility work, that could be a killer deal. I think they would stay for a very long time. The lease is a 10-year term, but they'll probably stay for 20 or 30 years. The crack have been filled at the parking lot. The slurry seal and stripe that will happen around the whole property will be done before the end of October. So in a couple weeks, we'll have some really fun before and afters. Landscaping, parking lot, paint cleaned up, and then the new monument sign rendering is in the works. So we've got a quick and rough rendering that we did, but we're gonna have a professional designer do a new design for a monument sign that will get us the maximum height of the sign that the city will allow, and then also the maximum area. So there's, you know, codes by the city that determine how much is allowed based on how many linear feet are there, and all the other requirements. Okay, now let's cruise down to Tempe. So this is the deal that I'm still in escrow to purchase. In fact, we have gone non-refundable. But I was on cloud nine just a couple weeks ago because we were at the altar getting ready to tie the knot and seal the deal with a medical tenant to take the entire facility. And the deal blew up in the 11th hour. In fact, the tenant just left me at the altar. Not a lot of substantial reasons why. It just went from, you know, 80 miles an hour down to a screeching halt and they did a 180. But that's how it goes sometimes. So I think my biggest takeaway or lesson learned is that I want to never be reliant on a single tenant. I want to have multiple tenants circling and offering at any given time. I want three LOIs. I want them all, you know, working hard and hustling to get their first month's rent and security deposited and get it signed, because there's two other qualified tenants who also are excited about that location, and make sure that we always stay in a position of strength as the landlord when we're negotiating. So that's I think a lesson that I learned the hard way on this one. And maybe it was more of a emotional roller coaster than anything, because I was so excited about that tenant and that deal getting done and being able to close that immediately after purchasing the building. But instead, we're gonna end up closing that vacant with a couple of good tenants circling and negotiations happening. And so hopefully we can sign a lease shortly thereafter closing with one of those awesome tenants that are excited and interested in the space, that have offered on LOIs, that have toured. So we're doing some things with understanding the construction costs for those tenants and the TI, tenant improvement allowance requirements, and some of the complexities with demising a large former drugstore and what's entailed with that. So that's where we're at with Elliott. That should close about October 15th if everything goes according to plan, which it will, because I'm non-refundable a bunch of money. And then finally, head out just east of Mesa to a little town called Gold Canyon. I bought a vacant former church there a couple weeks ago, and I signed a lease with a tenant, a nice 5-year term. They had a cool seminar business, financial education, and sadly, the tenant passed away from COVID. The guy was only 41 years old, so it's just an absolute shock, devastating, and so, you know, frustrating to, you know, have the deal done. But I think it puts into perspective everything that, you know, this commercial real estate stuff is, in the grand scheme of things, you know, not all that crazy when you think about, you know, life and how fragile it could be. So our thoughts go out to his family and his business partner, and you know, just wild. I've never dealt with that before. I think none of us have dealt with something like that before. So that's crazy. We're back out on market trying to figure out a great user to take that space. And what's wild is this is a deal that I probably would not have bought unless I had a tenant, you know, in my back pocket secured. And so that changes things a little bit, and I'm scrambling to find that new tenant so that we're not bleeding. But I want to get the right tenant in there, someone who's going to be a good fit, take the whole space. So We will market aggressively on Facebook, on LoopNet. We'll get it out there on Craigslist. We'll make sure the brokers in the community know. We'll probably reach out to some of the residential realtors in that community as well, because it is a small town of only about 10,000 people. We'll make sure everyone who's doing deals in that town knows that that space is available and that we've got good signage out there as well. So that's Gold Canyon. And then finally, last but not least, we have our Tucson property, the Albertsons anchored shopping center, up for sale now at about $4.6 million. So if anyone out there is looking for a grocery anchored shopping center with about a 7.5 cap rate of return, that could be a good one to look at. You know, we're interested for tax purposes to close before the end of the year, because I think we can lock in those 20% capital gains rates in 2021 versus what will likely be a higher capital gains rate if we wait till next calendar year. So some of the fun complexities of tax planning when your politicians are up in the air and not quite certain what the environment's gonna look like next year. It's like, take the bird in hand versus the maybe deal next year. We'll see. If we have a buyer step up at a good price, we can pull the trigger on that. And now that we're 100% occupied, that property is really, you know, at its best place to sell to a turnkey user who just wants to buy and hold and make great cash flow. So let me know what you think of all the action on those properties. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions. If you haven't already, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe so you get more behind the scenes updates. You can see the follow-up work happening with each of those deals and the paint job and the parking lot that's coming up here soon, and the leasing progress that we're having at each of these properties as well. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll talk to you soon.